Assalamu alaikum and welcome all. I hope that you will be enjoying a happy and healthy life. Viewers, today I am going to use a chemical pesticide first time ever in my garden. So I thought of sharing it with you. Till now, in all my videos, I have been talking about organic pesticides and other home remedies to control pests, insects and other foliage diseases. Neem oil was top of the list. And that was working well to reduce and to control those problems. So now you will be thinking that why suddenly I shifted to the chemicals. In fact, honestly speaking, till date, I'm neither convinced nor comfortable to use any chemicals in my garden, especially for kitchen gardening. But unfortunately, I'm left with no other choice, and let me show you the reason behind this choice. Now look at it carefully. As soon as I will dig a little bit, you will see some fast moving creatures running here and there, and I hope you can notice them as they hide so quickly. These are either centipedes or millipedes. I'm not sure about it, but whatever it is, I don't like them in all my pots. It looks disgusting and sometimes dangerous too, because their population is continuously increasing. So I'm trying to make a point that this time it's not a foliage problem, it's soil problem. And to treat the soil, I had to use that chemical. And not only these ones, but here there is another thing I will show you it. There is another type of insect also in this pot. See this one. I hope you can see it clearly. I think these are roly-polies, right? Correct me if I'm wrong, or you may know it by a different name. Anyways, they are only in this pot under the palm. And I didn't find them in any other pot in my garden, not even the garden, in the garden beds. But those centipedes or millipedes are everywhere in my garden, in all the garden beds even. Probably they were already present in the sand which I have used in my pots. Actually, I tried neem oil to treat the soil, but that only works well for leaves, not for the soil. And then I tried drying up the soil a few pots under the sun to get rid of these insects, but it can only be done with empty pots or with extra soil. It's not feasible for annual plants which are in these big pots, or for the trees in the ground. Actually, they are everywhere, not only in the pots but in the garden beds also. So this situation has forced me to use a chemical pesticide and get rid of them as soon as possible before the further spread. So finally, we bought this chemical pesticide from a horticultural shop. It was a little expensive and this was the minimum packing available. It's mentioned here that it's in concentrated form. So basically it's meant for commercial use, like farmers and nursery people. And here they have shown that against which insects it will be suitable. Altogether 12 types of insects and pests are mentioned here. And the dosage is also mentioned here for different types of crops and plants. But I will use it as per the recommendation of the shopkeeper or the salesperson, who said that one cap of this pesticide would be enough for 20 liters of water. And guys, please don't forget to use gloves and mask when you are using such chemicals. In fact, I am a bit scared also because it is first time for me to use this, and I think all of us should be not scared but a little more careful, because these are the poisonous chemicals and they have really bad side effects if inhaled, or in case of skin contact they will burn your skin. That's why I am telling you to use to take all precautionary measures and then use them. In fact, it doesn't smell that bad as I was expecting it. It smells like sprit, or you can say like thinner. Okay, here I have used one cap for 20 liters water to treat the soil. But if you want to use it as a foliar spray, then dilute it more by adding more amount of water. In fact, you can even double the amount of water. It can be one cap of pesticide for 30 to 40 liters of water. It actually depends upon the spread of the disease or pests in your garden. So we will start with these roly-polies. I'm trying to pour the mixture towards the edges of the pot to not to allow the insects to escape. Otherwise, they will escape and spread all over the garden. And viewers, whenever you are using any pesticide or insecticide, either be it organic or a chemical, let it be for soil treatment or for foliage treatment, please use it in the evening hours. I mean, avoid using it under direct sun or under sharp sunlight, as it can burn the plant. Let's see what the roly-polies are doing. Oh my god, they are climbing upon the trunk now. So in this case, I will pour some pesticide on the trunk also, so that they will not hide in between these dry layers of the trunk. Look at the effect of the chemical. Within no time, how many came out. Otherwise, you can't even notice them in dry soil. Now I can see that this chemical pesticide would be useful, inshallah. But still, I will try this in few of this side pots and the same side of garden bed, because this is a smaller area comparatively and I have few plants here. Then secondly, I have noticed some termite also in my moringa tree here. Hopefully you can see it. Let me show you from the other side. Yes, and so here also I will use that chemical. I know it cannot cure termite, but I hope that it can stop the further spread over the tree. So let's try it for moringa also. So viewers, this was my first experience of using such strong chemical in my garden, and inshallah it will work. If it will work, then I will use it in rest of my garden beds and other pots also. And soon I will share its update with you. Please do share this video with your friends who are facing such problems in their garden. And if you have some other solution or recommendation regarding this issue, please share it in the comment box so that all of us can benefit from each other's experience and enjoy gardening. Thanks a lot for watching the video. See you with next video. Till then, take care, stay blessed, and Allah Hafiz.